everybody to another Endless Theory event.
Feel the intensity in the crowd and on the racetrack.
They're saying he's going to be the one to watch today.
All these drivers all with one goal, become the champion.
Buckle up tight, folks. Here we go. Green flag is out. Hidden Valley. We're making history here in the NSCRA, the first time ever that these drivers have been introduced to this road course in an NSCRA circuit. We are here at the week number 7 for the running of the Duracell 250 version 1 as we get ready for division 1 of the Oreo Truck Series. On the point for this race going to be Ray Wilson in the 93. Alongside of him is going to be Trent Dunham. Charles Jackson going to line up there in third with Zohar Monod in fourth. Zach Buchanan going to run in fifth with Barney Ward starting this race in sixth. Seventh is going to be James McLeod and Cody Yamas in eighth. Pretty interesting. You got the two Budweiser cars, even though one's retro and one's up to date. You got Trent Dunham there in the red Budweiser truck in second and Charles Jackson in the black Budweiser truck in third. This is going to be a very interesting racetrack. We'll show you all the different things that this track's going to bring to the table in just a moment. But we're going to get these cars rolling off for their pace laps, and we will show you the starting grid for today's race. A nice aerial view of all these drivers going by as they prepare themselves for a track they've never been at before, Hidden Valley. And here is your starting grid for today's race. Fundamentals to it. One fundamental, though, that it does not have is elevation changes. So that's going to be interesting to see how these drivers are going to be able to figure out the difference between this track and Infineon where we normally race. But here we go. This long front straightaway is going to maybe be a key factor into who wins this race as they will come down here to the stripe. Ray Wilson getting ready to get us underway for 10 laps of racing here in the Duracell 250 version 1. The green flag is now in the air as we are underway here at Hidden Valley. Driver's going to be trying to make their moves here, but I wouldn't make too evasive moves right now. Basically, I think lap one's going to be a learning period for these guys, because remember, they've qualified, but they have not raced in traffic with each other. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens here as they remain double wide, but Ray Wilson's going to take the early advantage here. Look at him coming off this corner. Looks like everybody's good to go, though. Nobody going off the racetrack, so this is a pretty wide racetrack, as a matter of fact. This road course, not real narrow, and here they come through this hard, hard left-hand hairpin turn. Ray Wilson going to keep the top spot, and he's starting to pull away as well. Good battle back here for second. That's between Trent Dunham and Charles Jackson, the two Budweiser trucks. Jackson, whoa! Jackson got loose through that corner. That was close. Almost contact with Trent Dunham. And now they're coming to the hardest turn of them all there, these Hest curves, and then the very hard left-hand turn to get to the front straightaway right here. That's the worst turn of them all, and whoa, look out, Zach Buchanan. Whoa, someone's in the dirt. That's Zohar Monod. Zohar Monod's around into the dirt. Caution flag is waving. Zohar Monod threw into the dirt area. I think there are maybe a few other people in the sand pit there. This is LeJay Wilson. Oh, Zohar Monod just hit the inside retaining wall. Eric Burton, he's in it. Look out, everybody slip and slide. Oh, Jeff Ayers must have been involved in something earlier. He's got damage. So is Chris Dollerton, making his debut here in the trucks. Chris Dollerton driving the 83. A tough break for him. Nicole Sanchez got a piece of something. And the caution is out. Ray Wilson, the leader, under caution. We must have had two different wrecks occur. And we're going to have to look back and see both of them as we're under the caution for the first time today here at Hidden Valley. Well, here's a look at it. It was T.O. Bain. Let's see if we can get a good camera view. Oh, this will be a perfect camera view. T.O. Bain right there. You see him kind of running with two tires in the dirt and two tires on the track. That's not going to help for grip. That car's going to go down, bounce into the wall. And then, oh no, that car slingshots around. But I don't think he comes back up onto the racetrack. Someone else gets into something here. Oh, it was last week's winner. Red Bell gets turned dead into the wall by Sam Young. Sam Young then rams into T.O. Bain. Oh, Catherine Young got the wall back there. Chris Dollerton gets into Red Bell. Eric Burton runs into T.O. Bain. And oh, it's just on from there. Jacob Cook, Nicole Sanchez, Alex Jones. They just start running into each other here. Can't avoid him. Oh, Logan Wilson. Oh, it's Brian James there in the 17. He's in it. Richard Johnson leads the shoes slow up there to try and avoid that wreck. Look at that. Look at the cars just littered all through here. My goodness. David Rochester and Rhett Yates, they're held up by this. Don LaPrade as well, but I don't think they were involved. And now let's look further up. Zohar Manad, well, see how he got off the track. Right, oh, it was a three-wide situation. And really, that's not going to work. Watch them bouncing off each other. Oh, Zohar, I think, may have taken the turn too hot, too. Yeah, same deal that T.O. Bain did with Zohar Manad. Look at James McLeod. Slid off that corner. Hit the rumble strips. Hits Pichu London. Or not Pichu London, I'm sorry. That's Barney Ward. And then those three are going to go into a three-wide situation. Oh, I don't think Barney Ward appreciated what James McLeod did. Came back down and kind of bounced into the 40s up to say, hey, get off of me. But take a look here, coming off of this corner. This was a four-wide or three-wide battle for, I think it was the fifth position. And right there, three-wide is not really going to work here. And Zohar Manad gets the short end of the stick there as his car is going to slide into the dirt. Absolutely no grip for the 39 to be able to get anything to be able to keep himself on the racetrack. And there you see it right there. The car is going to snap through the dirt, through that sand pit, and go sliding there off of the final corner. Zohar actually, for some reason though, when he got his car going, he hit the inside pit wall. I'm not exactly sure why he did that, but that may have just taken him out of this race. And also LaJay Wilson, I think we're going to see in just a moment here, go sliding through this corner as well. Trying to see if we can find out from an aerial view here. Where's LaJay? There's LaJay Wilson. Yep, slides off through the corner as well. So Hidden Valley playing havoc with these drivers early on here in the Duracell 250. So we'll get ready to go back under the green flag. Two drivers out after the incidents that just took place. Eric Burton and Chris Dollerton. Dollerton, his debut, not the way he wanted to debut. He'll finish in the 40th position. Here's the top 10 as we get ready to go back to green flag racing. Ray Wilson leads. Trent Dunham second. Charles Jackson third. Zach Buchanan fourth. James McLeod is fifth with Barney Ward sixth. Seventh is Cody Yamas. Eighth, William Duncan. Ninth, Rohit Vidarbu. And Tyler Manson completes the top 10. Back to green we will go. Ray Wilson out in front, but for how long? I wonder if Trent Dunham, Charles Jackson learned anything to be able to pass the 93 here. Or will Ray Wilson be able to pull away like he did last time? We're going to find out. Here they come, right down to the stripe. And right now the green flag comes out. They're literally right on top of the stripe before the green comes out. Whoa, look at him slipping there. Why, my goodness. Three wide situation. Charles Jackson wants to take the advantage through this corner. Three wide. Jackson, Dunham, Ray Wilson, and they make it work. Oh my goodness, this is bad. This is still three wide. Still three wide. Whoa, Ray Wilson slips up. He'll have to bail out of it. It's now between Jackson and Dunham. Zach Buchanan off the track. Buchanan, he was running fourth, and he slips off the racetrack. I don't know if he got the wall or not, but now it's side by side again between the two Budweiser cars. It's Charles Jackson in the 29, Trent Dunham in the 8. Here they come through these very tricky S-curves as they're going to be coming up to him in just a minute here. Whoa, Jackson gets loose again. Still hangs onto it. Still side by side between Jackson and Dunham. Here they come through the S's. Oh, they bounce off each other. They bounced off each other. And Dunham's going to get the lead. Jackson had to bail out of the throttle to avoid spinning as Ray Wilson nearly got off the racetrack there. Whoa, there goes Pichu. There goes Joseph Bryant, but they're going to bring it back onto the racetrack in the final corner. Oh, they're slipping through there. There's a lot of dust. Is everybody going to get through okay? Whoa! Logan Wilson awfully close. Yellow flag is out. Eric Matthews is on pit road. He must have been involved in something. But Dunham's the leader under caution. And we're halfway in this event. Wonder if Zach Buchanan may have been a possible cause of it as well. We saw him go off the racetrack. Oh, nope, nope. Looks like Buchanan actually continued. I think I see him back there about 7th. Nope, he's 9th, so he is still continuing. But the caution came out for Eric Matthews, and who's that behind him? Is that LeJay Wilson? Yes, it is. So two cars on pit road here. Must have had another pileup. We'll have to find out what it was. Trent Dunham leads under the caution flag. Take a look here. See what it was that involved LeJay Wilson. I'm trying to find the other car that was involved. Eric Matthews. Is he further behind here, or is he up ahead in the cause of this wreck? I'm trying to find the 31. Oh, there he is. Yeah, he... Oh, wait a minute. Well, I guess we can't really check back. Oh, there you go. Oh, Rhett Yates got a piece of it as well. Runs into the back of LeJay Wilson. I don't think we really have to look back to see what happened to Eric Matthews, because I think it was almost the same kind of a deal that happened with T.O. Bain when we went under the caution the first time. But he did jump back onto the racetrack. LeJay Wilson, Rhett Yates, nowhere to go. A three-car incident puts us under the caution for the second time today here at Hidden Valley. Well, lights are out atop the pace truck. We'll go back to green flag racing on lap 7 of 10. We've been under the caution twice, and the drivers out after those incidents are Rhett Yates, Jeff Ehlers, Brian James, Red Bell, Catherine Young, Sam Young, T.O. Bain now out as well, along with Zohar Manud, Eric Burton, and Chris Dollerton. The reason we didn't mention those other drivers during the last restart is because we had not cycled around a green or a full lap to be able to know if they had retired or not. So my apologies for that, but that is the case. Trent Dunham is the leader. Charles Jackson second. Third, Ray Wilson. Fourth, James McLeod. And fifth, William Duncan. Cody Yama sixth. Rohit Vadar was seventh. Joseph Bryan eighth. Zach Buchanan ninth. And Tyler Manson is 10th for this restart. We've had some pretty doggone good battles for the lead, especially that last green flag run. That was absolutely unbelievable with Ray Wilson, Trent Dunham, and Charles Jackson. A few times there, I thought they were actually going to wreck each other. Let's see if we can end up doing the same thing here, if we can have that kind of hard racing for the top spots. Here we go. Green flag comes out. Jackson looked like he was going to step out of line, but no. Ray Wilson's going to be the one to step out of line. That's for second place. Another car stepping out of line. William Duncan looking for fourth off of James McLeod. They'll go double file here into turn one. I think someone already spun through turn one, trying to look back there. Can't see anyone. Oh, yes, it was. It was Jacob Cook in the 15. And I think the caution came out for that. Trying to look here, see if I can find any lights. Yeah, I think the caution is out for Jacob Cook spinning off of the first corner in the 15. Let's quickly look up here, see if the pace truck is coming off. Yes, it is. Caution is out. Whoa, James McLeod nearly off the racetrack there. Back in the fifth position. Whoa! Cody Yamas and Rohit Vadarbu, did you see them? My goodness, how did they keep that together? Meanwhile, Ray Wilson side by side with Charles Jackson. That's for the second position. Ray Wilson's out of the dirt. Can he get it back up onto the racetrack? He loses third to William Duncan, fourth to James McLeod, and oh, he gets it to Cody Yamas. The pole sitter gets into the dirt and loses spots. Whoa, Lisa Shear spins around there in the dirt. There's also another car. Jack Richards in trouble. Oh, and Richards gets into the fence. Richards drove into the fence. Shades of Zohar Manud. And the caution is out. Trent Dunham, the leader, again, under the caution. And I believe the caution originally came out for Jacob Cook. We'll look back at the 15. See, was the original reason the caution came out. He spun right in the first turn on the restart. Now, here it was. Let's see if we can go to a good camera view to be able to see who did the turning. Guess we have to go to the aerial view here. Jacob Cook's got Richard Johnson beneath him. But he kind of goes off the pace anyway. Oh, Richard Johnson gets into Dylan Schwalenberg. That's where it happens. And then Schwalenberg comes up into both Lisa Shears and Jacob Cook. And Jacob Cook has to go into the dirt there. Into the sand as his car spins around. So it was actually Richard Johnson and Dylan Schwalenberg getting together. Jacob Cook and Lisa Shears just innocent bystanders. Nowhere for them to go. They're in that very tight left-hand first turn. So a tough break there for Jacob Cook and Lisa Shears, who both sustained some damage, but Lisa Shears also spins off the final corner along with Jack Richards. Let's look at that. Well, here's a look at Richards. This was coming off the final corner. He's side-by-side with David Rochester, and I don't think they even make any contact. No. Richards just spins the thing around. There's Toby Ward trying to get his way through that. Yeah, Richards just spun the car around there in the dirt, in that sand, and nobody at all got into him. Just a single car spin there for Jack Richards. But then watch this. This is, I don't think we really showed it with Zohar Manad. So basically, this is the same thing that happened to Zohar Manad. And that's what retired him from this race. Watch right here as Richards tries to, I don't know if he tries to come back onto the racetrack and can't because these cars are all on the left of him or what. But watch right here. Richards trying to, I think he's trying to bring his car back up onto the racetrack. But instead, he just drives his car straight into the entrance of the pit row, the entrance wall. I don't know what the deal is there. Or I don't know if they keep forgetting that it's there, that wall is there, or what. But Richards, his car's smoking. I think that car's going to be retiring as he basically takes himself out of this race. He could have brought his car back up onto the racetrack and been able to continue on. But Trent Dunham leads it under the caution. I think we're getting ready for a shootout here at Hidden Valley. Well, I thought we were going to, but no, we're actually having the white flag waved right now. And the lights are still on atop the pace truck, which means Trent Dunham has picked up his first truck series victory of his career. And it comes here at a road course at Hidden Valley. I thought for certain we'd get back to green flag racing, but that's not going to be the case. So Trent Dunham, depending on whether any mechanical problems go on in that 8 car on this lap, this final lap, Trent Dunham's going to pick up his first Oreo Truck Series victory. He drove the 8 last season in his rookie season, was winless, and now this season he's going to have a win coming here at Hidden Valley. Saw some great racing between himself and Charles Jackson, who's going to finish in second, so pretty nice to see those two finish in 1 and 2. After that incredible performance they put on there, especially during that one green flag run, William Duncan's going to finish the day in the third position. Great run for him. James McLeod will be fourth, and Cody Yama's going to finish fifth. Sixth is going to be Rohit Vaidaravu. Seventh place, Zach Buchanan. Joseph Bryan, eighth. Callum Wales, ninth. And Barney Ward is going to finish the day in the 10th position. Well, certainly it's going to be interesting next week, or next race, to see what's going to happen, because we're going to have our points leader in Division 2, Sean Henley. Sean Henley coming off a big momentum run, ended up finishing third last week at Texas after he came in tied with Brandon Gonzalez for the points lead. And Brandon Gonzalez has recently departed from the Oreo Truck Series, was replaced by Chris Dullerton, who we mentioned earlier on, retired in the 40th position in his debut. But here we go. Off the final corner, no indications for pit road. All systems seem to be go for Trent Dunham to come down the long front straightaway here at Hidden Valley. And Trent Dunham is going to pick up a road course win. I don't know if Trent Dunham really considers himself a road course driver. We've never really seen him do a lot in the road course races, but does a lot today, is he's going to end up winning the Duracell 250 version 1. Congratulations to Trent Dunham. Great run for Charles Jackson in second. A great battle between those two. And we will now show you the official finishing results as history has been made here today. A race has been run at Hidden Valley here in the NSARA. Hope you guys will tune in for race number 2, Division 2. That'll be coming up very soon. We continue on what's going to be an exciting race weekend here at Hidden Valley. You've been watching an NSRA production, offline racing at its best.